It is a fine day for psychology. I'm Dr. Ferdinand Social, and I am on my way to determine the cause of the grisly murders in the city of London. This is the axe. I refrained from getting it in the last video, but somebody said he would like to see what the different weapons look like. That was the dagger. You've already seen that. That was at the beginning of the game. So yeah, as you can see, the axe is, it's decent. Like I said, it doesn't have the range that the cane has. Yes, the weapon that I was referring to is a hammer, or the hatchet is actually a cane. Which makes sense, considering the time frame and the setting of this game. So, yeah, chalk that up to just being a dumb yank. There's the dagger again, which I definitely do not want. The axe is pretty good. If I didn't have the cane as my primary weapon, the axe would be my secondary choice. And then the sword. I'll get that to demonstrate what it's like. My main problem with the sword is that the hitbox for it is so narrow. It's like, it's a thin little line, and you have to hit... Hey, why not? You have to hit your target with it exactly in order to hit, and it's just a pain. You definitely want to make sure that you have at least an axe or a cane by the boss at this level, because if you just have a dagger, then you're not going to do very well, as I have discovered in the past. This is the boomerang subweapon. It's not as good as the bomb, but it's okay. If you actually hit something with it, then it doesn't come back to you, which kind of defeats the purpose of a boomerang. Well, I guess that's how boomerangs in real life work. Doesn't Dr. Social just look so proper in his blue suit? He looks like the world's least likely vampire hunter. Also, in response to criticism that I got, I turned the background music up a little bit. I had it down pretty low because I'm not a huge fan of the music in this game. I guess it's not terrible. It's clearly trying to imitate the Castlevania music. And the Castlevania music, I mean, those games had, you know, some of the best soundtracks in Nintendo history. And it just can't live up to it. Plus the The audio hardware for the Master System was pretty miserable, too. I hope I get another weapon before I reach the boss. Otherwise, this is gonna suck. I might be able to do some damage with my boomerang, though. Oh no. I'm at the boss and all I have is a dagger. I'm boned. It's not that the boss is particularly hard. It's just that pretty much what you have to do in this game is just, for this boss is just trade blows with him. And if you just have the dagger, then he is going to overpower you with his blows. That lightning's pretty epic. I might be able to pull this off. If I can refrain from getting hit too many times. Almost got him. That did it. Man, that was close. Alright, let's see who this mysterious mass murderer was. This unknown mass murderer in late 1800s London. Who could it possibly have been? Oh, Jack the Ripper. Well, that makes sense. Go to the House of Wax, if I dare. okay, this sounds like a terrible idea. I don't want to do that. Why would I go to this place that this random guy just tells me to? When he was sort of responsible for a serial killer. That is not a very good idea. Alright, good old Kane. Time to do some bashing. And I'm not talking about Unix here. Oh, 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 nerd humor. Or nerd non-humor. Whoa! In many cases, these things are just easier to jump over than a fight, but, they're easy to take out with a cane. One hit does the trick. Let's see if there's anything worthwhile over here. Nope. Still quite a few weapons that I haven't shown off yet. There is the, here we go, the sword. As you can see, it has a pretty decent range, but like I said, see, if that was a cane, then those two hits would have hit that bat. But since it's a sword, your blow has to be more precise. Also, it's just kind of slow and sluggish. And it's not very powerful. It takes numerous hits to kill people. Not my weapon of choice. Even though it's the weapon so epically portrayed on the box art. That was some pretty epic box art for the time, though. Very high quality. Oops. In this room, we have to just basically kill an onslaught of these wax figures until they stop. And listen to a weird, monotonous beeping sound in the process. Ow. Apparently only two of them appear at a time, which is good. There are rooms similar to this one later on that are much more difficult, but these aren't too bad. Alright, in this room you want to hold to the right because there's a power-up if you drop over on this side. I forget if it's anything good or not, but it's there. Let's see. Oh, it's the cane. Good show. Oh. And there's some health here. Nice. Whenever you see a mass floating above a drop to the next level like that, it's usually going to be a 1-up. But in that case, the power-up is actually just a boomerang. Which is pretty lame if you try for it and you're hoping for a 1-up and, you know, you replace your superior sub-weapon with a boomerang. It's kind of, kick in the face. Do I want to go for those masks? Nah. No point. I don't think there's anything good up there. I don't know if I have time for another level or not. Better not risk it. This has been Duke of the Bump, and I will see you next time on Let's Play Master of Darkness. Later.